I'm here with the darkness, guys. Say hello to everybody at home.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, everyone
home.
At home.
I've just seen you with Download. It was great. I got right to the front. I stood there all day to be at the front for you guys.
Did you not get sunburned then?
I did get sunburned. It was
I wasn't
it was
looking,
not
I was
good.
Reading the question.
I forgot that my chest sticks out and I got really sunburned on my chest because we never get good weather in the UK.
Well, did you just call them the Majestics?
Sorry?
Did you just refer to them as the Majestics?
No, I didn't.
Oh,
I didn't.
Okay,
but that
what
wasn't
did you
something
say? Say
that
again what you said.
I said I forgot my chest sticks out.
I thought you said I forgot I had
yeah.
the Majestics out.
I thought you said that as well.
That's what I'm going to call them.
This
now.
Is my accent, but you know, I mean, I have to say, give credit where credit is due.
I forgot she had the Majestics out.
And I actually saw the video from your viewpoint and saw how big the crowd was, which I couldn't see because
yeah.
I was right at the front. Mm. And they looked like fields of corn when they were clapping. They looked like fields of corn. It was biblical.
Yeah.
Good idea for a song there.
Fields of corn?
Yeah.
With a K. See?
No, we were the real corn.
Yes,
that's
because
where we
the
were.
Corn was on the other stage.
That's right.
That's
you said we had to make more noise than them, and I think in everybody's minds we definitely
yeah,
did.
Like
but the crowd was huge.
Yeah,
the crowd was huge. So I think we definitely. I mean, for me, you were the real headliner.
Oh, that's such a sweet thing to say.
I know,
thanks.
But that's absolutely true for me, most definitely. And also, being under Steel Panther is a bit of a dodgy thing, isn't it?
Yeah. I was just to make that joke when the first album came out because it came in underneath Beyonce and then I was doing all that. You wouldn't be able to do those jokes anymore, would you? I'd be surprised if I get away with that Majestics remark earlier.
It'll be one of those moments, you know, like Headbangers Ball. Do you remember the time when Justin said that? It'll be
yeah.
like that.
And then they'll be like, Justin, the older guy that they cancelled. Oh, yeah.
Now, being a festival, though, you really had to do the songs that everybody knows.
Yeah.
But there was a sort of joyous moment at the end.
Mm.
And tell us about that.
This was Dan's idea, actually. I think you suggested doing the Christmas song, didn't you? And I was 100% behind it. I thought it was like, what a brilliant idea. It was a moment of genius on Dan's part because I think when you have a... We're like, everyone calls us a one-hit wonder, but they forget we had two hits.
Many
song.
More.
We had a pair of hits.
In the hearts of
we had
of
two
your,
massive hits.
In the hearts of people
massive
that
pair
matter.
Of hits.
The Majestics.
The Majestics. We should change the name of the band to The Majestics and keep the two massive hits. Yeah.
And so when you did the Christmas song, security looked a bit nonplussed, but the crowd just totally went with it.
What were the security doing?
Well, thinking... What's going on? Mind you, when they got to Steel Panther and they didn't know it was comedy, first of all, it started to get really surreal for them. But it began with the Christmas song, I think.
Yeah.
Christmas time.
You know what security are like, though. They're probably starting to think, oh, hang on, I haven't bought any presents yet.
Yeah, they're all checking out.
This is great. So now every security man is going to want to punch in the face.
I mean, the only problem for me was it was just too short.
Yeah, there's a reason why that happened. Motorheart was supposed to be in the set, but somebody forgot to write it on the set list.
Oh.
So, it was supposed to come after Given Up, wasn't it? And I went over to Dan and said, you know, Motorheart's not on the set list. And then Guitar Tech would have had to prepare a Charvel for me, something in the special tuning for Dan, and Frankie would have had a differently tuned bass. And nobody was prepared for that song, so we had to walk around and say to each other, we're just going to have to drop Motorheart. So we didn't play anything from the new record, which is genius, obviously. And we ended up being 4 minutes early. So.
Oh, right. Now, I understand, Frankie, it was you that listened to Motorheart and said it was like Motorhead and Heart, and that's how it got given that name.
Well, I don't claim any credit for that, because all I was saying is that it sounded what it reminded me of. But I do give credit to Justin for taking that as an idea and then calling it Motorheart and writing it about... sex bot, or what's the expression?
No, I think it's more love robot.
Love robot. Love robot.
You're talking to a girl now, don't forget. I mean, for me...
You've got to do the interview completely differently.
Yeah, exactly,
none
exactly.
of the things we've normally say.
exactly. And one of the reasons why you were the real Sunday headliner for me was the showmanship. Because, you know, Kiss and Maiden... They have these massive shows. That's what we're used to in rock music. That's what classic rock is.
Mm.
And now you guys are younger And these guys are not going to carry on, and you are going to have to carry the torch.
Do you think we'll
you
be
guys?
The maiden and kiss?
I think you will. I hope so.
Wow.
Because, you know, people want to go and see a show. And if the younger bands are not going to do it, you know, like, I mean, the 20-year-olds or whatever, then it's up to you guys to carry the torch,
yeah,
because you're the generation down from Kiss and Maiden and the ones that are doing it now.
Wow. Thanks for that. No pressure.
I mean, what are your other live plans? I think one of the reasons I'm here today is a big announcement.
Yeah, there's a big announcement. So, well, we've got a few more festivals to do, first of all. Then we've got, what have we got? Oh, yeah, we're going to Australia.
That's fantastic, except you'll be tired.
No, I never feel tired. Tiredness is for the weak-minded.
No.
I think we'll be fine.
I'm the weaker sex, though, so that's why I feel tired.
No, why are you going into this gender politics all the time?
That's because you only do that with your good friends.
All right, then. So, and then, in January, we're doing the co-headline arena tour with the Blackstone Cherry Music Quartet.
Yeah, absolutely. Why Blackstone Cherry?
Blackstone Cherry, first of all, were the ones that invited us. It was their idea. We've known those guys for about a decade. We played with them in Thetford Forest. And that was a big show for us. It was 2012, I think, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
They have an audience that is compatible with our own. They put on a great show, great songs, lovely people. And they'll be a really enjoyable band to tour with. And they very kindly suggested that. And we were like, yeah, okay, that sounds absolutely brilliant. And the most important thing is that we'll get to do some arena production stuff, which we haven't been able to do in our own right for a long time. We've been in the rooms because we've played with, you know, we've supported other bands in those rooms. But now to do a sort of co-headline thing where we can actually focus on a bit of production, it's just really exciting.
So will you be special guests for them? Who will go first?
I think because, you know, we're of an age now where we like an early night. So
I know the feeling.
You know, so we'll let those young whippersnappers go on after us.
Okay, so you will definitely be special guest, and no less, I'm probably...
Special guest, no, this is a...
Co-headlining. I know, well, sorry, I read the press release. It's co-headlining, everybody, it definitely is.
According to the press release and reality, it's a co-headline.
Will there be a new record by then? Because I noticed that...
Only in your wildest imaginations.
Well, I'm good at thinking things, I'm making them happen.
I think we have to consider it sort of... That's a tour that we might release something, but I don't think it'll be an album. It's kind of like the back end of the Motorheart, but also transitioning into like the other thing about next year is that it's like a 20th anniversary of Permission to Land, so it's kind of
okay.
This tour is going to be something that bridges the gap between the 20th anniversary and the Motorheart.
Mm-hmm. And Motorheart is on the poster. So it's obviously...
Oh, yeah, the ladies. On yeah, so,
yeah.
Yeah, so this
yeah,
is Motorheart.
She's definitely on the poster.
It's probably our last sort of engagements of the Motorheart.
Right,
range.
Okay. Now, the idea is futuristic. What do you guys think of the ABBA avatars and the Dio hologram and all of that business?
I haven't seen it, but I've heard only amazing things from people firsthand who've been there.
Folk have said to me that the technology that the ABBA thing employs is such that we cannot even conceive of how they did it.
Okay.
And I said, what, is it just holograms? I went, yeah.
We're actually thinking of doing our own version. We're going to call it the Darkness ABBA Guitar Tour.
Okay. I mean, the trouble is, I really want to see you guys. That's the problem. I don't think I'd be happy with holograms of you. I want to see the real thing.
Yeah, well...
Depends what the holograms are doing, though.
Yes, it's a Heineken Zero.
Yes,
done.
What do you think future gigs will look like?
You just put a vodka in the top of it.
You know,
for us or everyone?
Well,
everyone.
Both. You can cover both. You know, what will you? What
Good
will
question.
Your gigs
think,
look like in 10
can,
years' time?
I think you can expect. You can expect in about 100 years' time, a Kiss concert where it's fully hologram.
But I will
still
be a hologram too. I'll be
yeah,
a hologram
the
too. The audience will be too.
Maybe we should get some holograms for the audience, and then we wouldn't have to sell as many tickets.
But you know, I won't want to be there then. I'll be really old then, and I'll be saying, I remember real things,
yeah,
real things.
You remember reality.
It would surprise me if they're asking for holograms of Coke.
Brilliant.
But I actually love history, and I know, Dan, medieval history is your
That's
kind of thing. I'm going to go round you guys now. If you could time travel and go to any gig ever, so that includes Henry VIII's court or anything like that, anything you want, right?
I'm there when Henry VIII first plays Greensleeves.
I'm psychic, Dan.
And at that gig, I have an argument with someone, and it's settled with a sword, and I've killed that person. And then I eat a load of meat off the bone, virtually raw, and then pillage.
Well, I love medieval history, so we'll have to have a separate interview all about that.
It's a good one,
but moving on, which gig, either past or future, would
I'll
you go
future,
to?
I'll go future, I think. I want to be the first, I want to see the first gig on Mars.
Oh, that would be great.
It'd be lovely
to
see that sort of, the red
desert
scape.
I'm too lazy to go there.
Well, you'd be in cryogenically frozen. They thaw you out when you get there.
Okay.
You don't even notice it.
So
like
you don't get any sickness or
you
anything.
It might take nine years to get there, but you'll be...
Exactly. I'll be dead before anything that happens, I'm sure.
But the hologram can go. They just beam yourself as a hologram. Hologram.
Do you know what? You can actually book a ticket for that show now, take everyone's money, knowing that there'll be...
No chance.
Because
we would have killed ourselves by then, the whole human race. But anyway, well, we're on such a positive note.
The end of the world.
And actually, sad songs. There were some sad songs that you wrote in the pandemic.
Mm.
Do you think they'll ever see the light of day?
No.
You definitely buried them.
Flushed them down the toilet where they belong.
Does the band ever veto your ideas or your outfits? I want to know, right?
The band never does that, but what sometimes happens is I get such an underwhelming response to some things that I don't really want to pursue.
But your natural show-off just means you basically bury them.
Yeah, and then they get flushed down the toilet. So I often have to have a plumber come and clear the pipes away because it creates all kinds of havoc down there. And I am still talking about the plumbing of my house.
Now, the BBC said about you, in the context of Meatloaf, actually, Justin Hawkins of The Darkness uses his voice as a weapon. That's what they said about you.
What?
Yeah, that's what they said about you. And they likened you to Meatloaf as a result.
When did they say that?
Oh, when Meatloaf died.
Oh, wow.
So I want to know, how do you all want to be remembered? Oh, you didn't get to do your future gigs. You got your past and present gigs. You guys, you have to just stop hiding at the back there and come on, come forward.
Guys drinking pints.
What are your future gigs?
What I love is Rat Bananoff, Piano Concerto number 2, because he had huge hands and he was such a funny looking guy. And to hear him play those pieces on the piano.
That would go back.
Apparently he was one of the greatest ever piano players.
Ah.
But to have heard him debuting Piano Concerto number 2, I think would be incredible.
Okay.
Somewhere in
and Rufus?
In
I'm sorry.
I think I'd like to see Little Richard in his prime.
Oh, yeah. That would be amazing, wouldn't it? Yeah, that would be absolutely
Little
amazing.
Richard and then...
I'm almost old enough to have done that.
I think that concerto number 2 goes into a 7/14 Tarkin signature at one point, which is outstanding, isn't it?
So using his voice as a weapon, how do you all want to be remembered, including you, because presumably you don't want to be remembered as someone who uses his voice as a weapon.
I don't know if that's supposed to be a nice thing or a bad thing. What do you think they meant by that?
I think it meant that they find rock music scary. But we love it, so we don't care.
Yeah, I saw that then. I mean, to be remembered, but I mean, in a way, I'll be dead, so I won't care. But I just want the children to be safe. This is what I always say when I don't know how to answer a question.
Okay.
I think maybe I want to be remembered as someone who tried, really tried.
You know what? You always give 100% on stage.
I think that's important to
me. And that's important. I'll definitely say that about you. Should I outlast you? And as I'm female, I might. But I probably won't. So you'll be safe.
Of course
safe.
You will.
Because go on, Dan.
We're all going to live forever, Dawn. We're immortal.
I want to be remembered as the only person on the planet who was cremated alive.
Oh,
yeah,
don't do that today.
Right,
it's going to ruin the rating on my video.
I want to choose the time and place, and I want everyone to see it.
Emoliation. Are you going to do this?
Unless they press the button and the flames come up, and you're like, no, I'm not ready. I'm only joking.
Are you going to do this in name of a cause, Dan, or just attention seeking?
Just attention seeking.
Oh, okay, well, just get it clear.
I'm the other guy!
How to be remembered.
Remember the other guy! It's Dan!
I don't know. How to be remembered.
It's a really difficult question to answer.
Yeah, it's really difficult.
I'd like to be remembered as the man who launched 1,000 cowbells.
You did. I'm going to say that about you. If I outlast you, that's what I'll say they should
put
on your...
Or 1,000 moustaches. I can't say.
That's your epitaph.
The man of 1,000 tashes, either.
All of them exactly the same.
And you've got to think of something.
Okay. Man with the most powerful serve on the planet.
Wow.
Okay, all right. That's quite a high one. That's a high one.
Thor's hammer.
That's going to be hard for me to verify and put on your headstone.
It's nearly there, right, guys?
Yes, it's got to be up there.
Okay, and Rufus, your dad's got a huge public profile. Does he like the darkness?
He loves the darkness.
Okay, so that's great, isn't it?
Yeah,
absolutely.
I thought you were going to say penis then.
I thought.
Does he love the penis?
It's got a huge...
Happiness!
It's got a huge the darkness. Does he love the penis?
Recently, Justin, you said that what's the point? If you're not going to be amazing, what's the point? And I just wanted to say, I agree, and I think you are totally amazing, all of you.
Oh, thanks, Dawn.
Really
you're amazing,
sweet.
Too. That's really kind of you.
Thank you so much for making some time to talk to us.
It's always a pleasure, and it's never a chore.
Ever.
Always great to see you and the Majestics. You're welcome anytime.